So I'm associated with the Virtualization Technology Users Group, and the thing that that we found that community is that that VMware obviously very important, but we began to see that there was more and more interest in a multi-hypervisor community, because it isn't just VMware, and some of the members that we had were also saying, hey, you know, my bosses are telling me, look, you're already a VMware expert. Why are you going to these events to learn more about VMware? Don't you know everything about it? So obviously they don't. There's always more to learn. But they said, hey, what else is out there? Well, you know, should we be taking a look at Microsoft? Should we be taking a look at KVM? What's going on with the cloud? So all of these things, we had a light bulb over our head, said we have to become the first multi-hypervisor virtualization technology users group. And that's why we became VTUG. And the responses have been astounding. We're based in New England. We have over 5,000 members in 30 different countries. So we're international. And so there's a real demand for it. Whenever we have a Microsoft lab or a webinar to talk about Hyper-V, they fill up really fast. And so we know that there's a need out there, and we know that there's a real interest. And we believe that we made the right decision to be a multi-hypervisor, or I should say multi-platform users group. It's been exciting, and we think that that there's just so much more to explore here and grow. One of the things that that I'm observing is that Microsoft is really impacting the market differently than I've ever seen them before, and I wouldn't have predicted it. They're almost innovating at a level that a startup would. And you know, it's interesting because we always say that large companies can't innovate, but I'm not seeing that in this case. What they're doing with their cloud, with Azure, and how they're tying that into their virtualization as well. So they're pulling together all of these different solutions as a total solution versus just islands. And I think that's going to become more and more important over time, that we're not just going to look at and try to solve problems as point products. We're trying to say, hey, how do we tie all of these things in together? So Microsoft is taking a look at the total problem in order to provide a total solution. And I think that's very compelling. And that isn't to say that VMware does not have a strong presence in the virtualization market and won't continue to, but the dynamics really are happening in the way that I'm describing. VMware has a huge loyal base. They have excellent technology. They keep growing. But one thing that they failed to do is that they failed to create the next big thing, right? They have stayed with what they've done. They've made experiments outside of what they were trying to do, trying to get into the application space. So they have failed to reinvent themselves to take it to the next level. Microsoft is now saying, look, we know how to go after markets like this, and we're going to put a lot of attention to it. And I'm actually very impressed by how aggressive and how innovative Microsoft's been in this marketplace.